Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So I am so grateful to you guys that you guys are liking it, appreciating it and motivating me to put such more real insight. I am glad that today we are going to have a discussion on the law practice program, and the law practice program is offered by the Ryerson University for all the candidates who are going to become a lawyer in Ontario or who are going to immigrate to Ontario as lawyer or whatever your status may be, but this is specifically to Ontario lawyers. So this is like a substitute to articling, which is offered in by the Ryerson University in collaboration with the Law Society of Ontario. When the process starts after you are enrolled with the law licensing candidate with the Law Society of Ontario. And once you are done that, then you can, you know, choose that you want to get your articling exempted, or you want to do your traditional way of articling, or you can do the LPP. So there are three options for you. So now we are today in discussion with Raghav Jain. He is currently an LPP candidate and a very cool guy who's very active with all the networking in downtown. So I am, I'm going to share some insights with you. He's going to share some insights with you. I also did LPP back in 2018 to 19. It is an 8 months course, and I hope that you get the real market, real picture. And if you do, then you know what to do. You have to hit the like button because it makes the video recommending, and then we can create more awareness by that. And you can share and subscribe and do whatever you feel like. So let's start.
Hi Raghav.
Hi Shireen, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good, thank you.
Raghav, so I know about you, but I want you to introduce yourself to my audience, people who are listening to you, and just give a brief about yourself.
So I am a licensed lawyer from India. I completed my LLB from Punjab University in 2016, and I began writing the NCAs from 2017 to 2018. I began to write the bar examination of the Law Society of Ontario in 2019, and I finished my LPP this year, and I should get called to the bar in Ontario by September this year.
Okay, that's great. So now you can start by telling us, what is the law practice program? At what stage did you enroll yourself with the LPP? I have also done it, but I want you to explain everybody the insights, since you are an LPP candidate right now.
Right. So the LPP is an alternate pathway to getting licensed in Ontario. There are two ways to finish your training component in Ontario. You basically embark on this journey once you have finished your NCAs, which is the National Committee on Accreditation Examination. And interestingly, the LPP is only unique to Ontario. It's one of a kind program in Canada. And residents of Canada or even any other resident worldwide who has a law degree can enroll into this program. This program began initially in 2014. The brain behind this program was Mr. Chris Bentley, who is a former Attorney General of Ontario, and that was his brainchild. And throughout, from 2014 to 2020, the LPP has gone through a lot of ups and downs. The Law Society of Ontario was not in favor of the LPP initially, but the LPP did get a lot of support from the Ontario Bar Association. And each year they would hold a particular analysis and assessment of how the LPP is doing. I'm just going to rewind a bit for your viewers, Shireen, right now, just to tell the people as to why there was even a need for the LPP in the first place. Up till 2014, what was happening in Ontario is that the number of law graduates was increasing exponentially, but the number of articling positions at law firms were not increasing that much, because of which a lot of law students would miss out on their articling opportunities, which would potentially lead to a year. And Mr. Bentley saw this as a chronic problem. And given the fact that our province, in fact, Canada in particular, is committed to providing access to justice, and which is why, in order to fulfill that purpose, we do need more lawyers out there, right? And which is why Mr. Bentley embarked on this program, the LPP. And in the first few years, there was remarkable feedback from people with respect to the quality of candidates that were being produced in this program. As a result of which, these traditional articling people, they started like, okay, so what's wrong? Like, they're all like, oh, we are the best. Like, this is just a second tier. And people started looking down upon the LPP, that whoever could not secure traditional articling went down to secure the LPP. And the LPP does not have any fixed number that only, let's say, 50 or 60 people can do the LPP. It's indefinite. Like, whoever cannot secure traditional articling, you're all welcome in the LPP.
Yeah.
A brief history I wanted to share. Now, I'm just going to share what the LPP is with people. It essentially is composed of two segments, a training component of 4 months and a work component of 4 months, which is a total of 8 months, and you end up saving 2 months on traditional articling. So now I'm going to just stress a bit on what exactly each component is.
Yeah, sure.
The training component, essentially, the LPP team would divide all the candidates into virtual law firms, into groups of 3 or 4 people. We have a real-life mentor who evaluates all our assignments and gives us feedback. So a typical day in the LPP would be like you wake up at 8 o'clock and you would be having your morning assignment. You're just working from home, pretty much like what the world is doing during this pandemic. I think there's someone in an emergency, but I think we'll just wait for that siren to go off. Yeah, we're good now. So I was telling you about the mentors in an LPP. So yes. So on a typical day, you wake up at 8, you get a morning assignment, and you get pre-decided deadlines as to when it's supposed to be done. The LPP makes you work in a virtual office. There is a particular website that will be provided. Each person has an account. You are connected to all the other people in the LPP through that website. On that website itself, you have a separate component for the firm's legal resources, and there's a particular component for, you know, the assignments that you use, that you will be submitting, and those are called deliverables. As far as the firm's resources are concerned, the practice areas that a person would be getting acquainted to, which are criminal law, civil litigation, real estate, wills and estates, business law, administrative law,
immigration law.
And immigration law, yes, of course. So in those firms' resources, you will find lots of precedents, checklists, even videos which have been recorded from top experts in those particular fields in Ontario. And based on those videos and precedents and other texts available, we are supposed to be working on our assignments. And based on those assignments, we will be graded at the end of 4 months. It's very critical that a person finishes their training component and qualifies all the parameters and expectations that are required for a candidate. Otherwise, you will not be permitted to move on to the work component. And while this training component is on, we are simultaneously filing applications to potential work placements in the LPP. And each day is very different. You wake up and you have to docket your time every day. In the firm's resources, there are links to the softwares that you would be using in the LPP. Clio is one of those softwares which we use for docketing our time. And besides Clio, you will also be getting acquainted with legal resource softwares like LexisNexis and Westlaw. So yes, basically you will be imbibing all the skills that are necessary to become licensed in Ontario. And those skills include professionalism and ethics, analytical skills, research, oral and written communication skills, client management and practice management. And I must also categorically mention that one of the few things that the LPP gives us is client exposure. We interview clients through an online software remotely. Those clients are actually actors and the university pays them. And it's all a script and we need to question them. And accordingly, we build our case, we build our client files. And accordingly, the rest of the LPP keeps on snowballing from there. So it's very organic the way the LPP teaches you step by step. And as you go forward, you become more confident.
So basically, that was about the training component. So what about your work component? How was your 4-week work placement? And what was your experience in the work placement? Also, if you could just, in this question only, if you could just tell us that, are there chances that that work placement becomes a permanent placement, or does it only stay for 4 months?
Right. So there is a lot of competition in securing the best placement that you want, because there is a good candidate pool, high quality candidate pool, even in the LBP. And it's very tough to secure a placement in your area of interest. So I encourage everyone to be very open and apply widely when they do, and not be short-sighted. The skills that I learned during the training component were very, very helpful while working at my work placement. I ended up in real estate. I was never inclined towards real estate at all. In fact, I was quite scared of it because I did not do very well in my solicitor examination previously. And now it's actually kind of helping me. The LPP was very instrumental in clearing my basics, building that foundation, which gave me the impetus to perform well during my placement. And now when I will be writing my bar exam this June, I feel much more confident that I will be able to crack it this time. So yes, the work placement was very, very helpful. I have also been very fortunate that my employer extended my work placement. In fact, I encourage everyone to perform to the best of their ability during the work placement, because this is your first and only chance in Ontario, the moment you come here, to create an impression, impress your employer, because you do not know if that employer can refer you to someone later, and you do not know if that employer would be willing to hire you back. So it's very important that no matter where you get placed, whether it's in your area of interest or not, you give it 100% every day. And the kind of pay that people can expect is variable. There have been placements in the past where people did it for free. They were not quite happy. There have been placements in the past which went to as high as $6,400 a month with TD. So there is a whole variety, and it's only as good as you are, you will be getting that placement. But I also want to mention at the point that there's a petition pending in front of the Law Society of Ontario right now to make pay mandatory for our technical students. I don't know what's going to happen with that, but let's see. And also the LPP has been extended for another 5 years. So congratulations to everyone.
So one more thing, that how difficult as a foreign trained lawyer you think is to get a work placement of your choice? Because I have also done LPP, and in my opinion, I would like to say that it was not that easy, but it was not that difficult as well. It was somewhere in between, but it was not easy for sure, because I had to, you know, send my CVs everywhere and apply widely.
I was very certain since the beginning which area of law I wanted to get into. With each passing week and month, I became more and more disappointed and getting more and more disenchanted with my expectations, because I just wouldn't get an interview call because the pool was so diverse and high quality. But there is, you can say there is a kind of preference towards Canadian graduates from what I felt.
Yeah.
It's very difficult to convince someone over here that you have graduated from a very good university. Of course, they will give preference to a candidate who has studied from a Canadian university, because who knows about our standards? I mean, you know, they have no idea. They have no way to gauge what quality of law did we study.
Yeah.
So yes, I encourage everyone to, you know, but if you have some work experience from your home country, it does really matter over here while applying for a work placement.
Okay. And Raghav, if you can throw some light on the fee structure for the law practice program. I clearly don't remember, but I would like you to suggest something.
Right. So last year it was $2,800 plus HST, which is about $3,164. They may increase this year. Who knows? But yeah, it's just an estimate. It will be more than $3,000.
Which is fair enough, I believe, because in $3,000, you are getting such practical experience. And you know, which is very helpful. Even today when I use Clio or other softwares, I thank the LPP because the training component taught you a lot.
It's a massive, massive bargain. Just to give some context to your viewers about the kind of expenditure people make over here for law, an LLM at University of Toronto or York University would cost you $40,000 for just a year.
Mm.
At York University, a specialized certificate for 5 days is just $4,000. If you compare those things with what the LPP is giving you, $3,000, that's a steal right away.
So Raghav, as a last recommendation, can you suggest which people should do it, like who should do it and who should not do it?
I personally feel that everybody should do the LPP, and that is also the opinion of a former Attorney General of Ontario, I'm not naming him, but he said that in public, that in fact he was in favor of disbanding the entire articling program, the traditional articling program, and making everyone go through an LPP. Such is the chorus, you know, of the crowd. And especially in the Ontario Bar Association, people are very much in favor of the LPP. So to answer your question, who should be doing this? I think everyone. But I know there are certain people who want to, you know, just skip this whole training phase by getting their articling abridgment. Well, you will end up saving 8 months. Good for you. But as soon as you enter the job market, you're just not trained in Canadian standards. I mean, how will you perform? And as a lawyer, you need insurance, law pro insurance. And if you, you know, mess up, it's going to be bad. It's going to be bad to the extent that it's going to, your record is going to be public for everyone to see on the Law Society website. So, you know, it's better to train yourself, get trained, get acquainted with the legal skills, the kind of, you know, work that is expected of you. And, you know, then go forward in the profession. Like, why just jump the gun? I mean, that's my personal opinion. If people think that they are highly qualified and confident, then, you know, go.
Yeah, but I am also of the opinion that if you have a practical experience, say, in a law firm with the law as a law clerk or legal assistant, that also gives you an edge. So people who have, like, I took this interview of Saurabh. He was working as a law clerk and he got his articling exempted. But the whole law clerk experience in a firm gave him an edge to clear his bar exams. And also he thought that he had met that kind of Canadian standard, right? So I think it is person to person for sure. It is a very subjective thing. But yeah, LPP is, for that matter, you're right. For practical experience, it's too good with hands-on experience. Thank you so much for the whole insight that you've given us about the law practice program. I'm sure the viewers, maybe, you know, somebody get influenced and join the LPP, or people who are asking me also about the LPP. So also one thing I would like to clarify is that you can do the LPP even before your bar exams. Yeah, and you can do it even after your bar exam. So there's no such a mandatory rule that you have to do it primarily. All right. Thank you, Raghav. If you
You're
have
welcome.
Any last words you can share.
I would encourage everyone to give their best in this program and extract the most that they can.
Yeah.
And it is often said that the LPP is only as valuable as the effort that you put in. So just make the maximum use of the resources that are there at your disposal.
So guys, I hope this whole thing was useful for you. If you have any other query, question or concern regarding the LPP, put in the comment section. I can address all of them. Also, before I go, I would like to say that in the future, I'm going to interview a very successful and accomplished lawyer here in Ontario. She's also a Canadian law tutor. Like, she teaches a barrister for the bar exams of Ontario. So I hope you stay tuned and subscribe to my channel. Bye-bye.